struggle is over. See, what determines your struggle being over is when you have made up in your mind that I'm no longer going to go through what I've gone through before. I'm no longer going to deal with the mess I used to deal with. I'm no longer going to put up with all of the heartaches and the pain that I've gone through in the past, because what I've gone through in the past is no longer going to affect. God, I feel like preaching right now. It's going to affect where I'm going in my future. And so since I'm not willing to allow this thing to affect me in my future, I'm going to relinquish my stand. And I'm going to depend on God from this day forward. Before time, I depended on Johnny. And Johnny failed me. Before time, I depended on Susie. And Susie failed me. But this time, I've gotten mature enough. God, I've gotten mature enough now that I can stand on my own with the help of the Lord. If I can stand with the Lord, everything else that I go through really don't matter. I know folks have laughed at me in the past and said before that I'm not going to succeed. They said he's going to quit. They said she gonna quit. They gonna divorce. We're going our separate ways. But this time, baby, I got connected to somebody that's gonna be with me in the future. That won't let me down. I got with somebody that's going to be there if I'm all by myself. I got with somebody that tells me he loves me every now and then. You don't tell me you love me no more. You don't tell me how you appreciate me no more. But I got with somebody. God, I feel like preaching. I got with somebody that when I wake up in the morning, tell me, baby, you look good. I'm no longer down and depressed. I'm no longer frustrated and worried. I got some self-esteem now about myself. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me now. I got some self-esteem about myself. And if nobody else tell me they love me, I look in the mirror and tell myself, y'all ain't gonna talk to me now. See, because sometimes you got to talk to yourself. Y'all don't want to talk to yourself because somebody said if you talk to yourself, you must be crazy. Well, I found one thing out about God. And since I was created like him, I found out that God talks to himself. Y'all ain't going to talk to me tonight. And since I found out that God talks to himself, what are you talking about, preacher? How do you know that God talks about or to himself? Well, the Bible says that God counsels himself. In other words, to counsel yourself means to tell yourself, well, if I do this, then that's going to happen. Right. And if I do that, that is going to happen. Right. You know how you do it, baby. You counsel yourself. Mm-hmm. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing. I ain't lose nobody. You counsel yourself. You know how I know you counsel yourself? Because I counsel myself. And I created after God's image and after his likeness. Watch this here. When I talk to myself, I tell myself, y'all ain't gonna say nothing. And myself say, And I begin to tell myself, self, if you don't pay the light bill, you know you still got the car bill to pay. If you don't pay the car bill, you know you got a mortgage to pay. Well, you got... I talk to myself because my God talks to himself. And so I've gotten so bold now that I look in my mirror every morning and I tell myself in the mirror, mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the finest of them all? Y'all ain't... I wish I had somebody that'll pray with me just a little while longer. I tell myself, mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the finest of them all? And all of a sudden the mirror began to tell me in the reflection, you are. And since I already know it for myself, if you don't tell me I look good already, I feel like preaching now. If you don't tell me that I got it going on, I've already told myself. So I'm not waiting on somebody. I ain't got no problem. on with self-esteem, because my self-esteem has already esteemed itself, and I'm not waiting on nobody else to tell me how I look and how I feel. Many of us in the house of God, we come in depressed, down and out, and we're looking around waiting on somebody just to tell us, baby, it's going to be all right. Again in the scripture, and in the scripture I saw this man by the name of David. David was down and depressed, and he couldn't get anybody else to tell him that it was going to be all right. So what David did was, the Bible says David began to encourage himself. David began to encourage himself. See, because if nobody else can tell you that you look good, tell yourself, girl, you look good. Ooh, when you put this outfit on, you really gonna show them what it look like. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me in here. See, we've been putting on a lot of things to make us look good. All you got to do is just get in the mirror, find you the best mirror, the one that can see all of you. And when you find the best mirror that can see all of you, you got to know how to pose for the mirror. And let the mirror know, mirror, mirror on the wall, look how I look in them all. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing and turn to the other side and begin to say, baby, you look fine. Woo, God, y'all ain't gonna talk to me again. You got to know how to encourage yourself, because you got to let yourself know, I can do all things, y'all. You ought to get you the best mirror in the house. I'm not talking about the crack mirror. I'm talking about the one that shows you clearly. The one that you dust off and rub off. When you putting on your eyeshadow, y'all ain't gonna say nothing. When you outlining your lips, y'all ain't gonna talk to me. Because you wanna look good, baby. You already look good no matter what you got on. See, because you were created by God. The Bible says he looked at it and said, it's all good. Y'all ain't gonna say that to me. And so I look good. Whether you say I look good, my eyes may be big, my lips may look swole. Y'all ain't gonna say that to me. I might have a keg on me. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me in here. I know it don't look like a six pack. Some of us been working out far too long. What you need to do is get on the altar and repent before God. When you get it right at the altar, then you can go to Sue and say, Sue, I didn't like you at first, but I'm you can't get to the next level, huh, until you get it right. You can't go to the next level in God until you get it right, until you get yourself together. That's when you can go to the next level. That's when God can do what he want to do with you. Watch this, because I'm going to talk about what I'm talking about. Look at somebody saying, can he talk about what he's talking about? Well, if you don't like it, I am in it. I want you to understand this here. Some of us have been missing our blessings for trouble.